Game just crashed. I don't know. Don't know why this keeps happening, but never good enough hitting the wall.
Thank you.
Oh no. For some reason, the bump from that corner seems to catch me out all the time. Bumps or something else on this track for the radio. This car just makes you want to drive fast around all the corners, but sometimes you just gotta give it about 80%. Very difficult with no ABS with this car. It's so quick. Grass then. Very challenging track, but definitely a good one. Wow. Touch the curb. Seems to be one line around this track, and as soon as you get off that line, you're definitely in the wall. I can leave my seat in position higher a little bit. The trick is to be very gradual in the power. The moment you start putting your foot down too soon, coming out of the corner, going over bumps, and you just get further. I'd love to show you the rest of the track, if I could actually get there. Look a bit early then, touch the curve again. Them bumps in such an awkward place. Right, once I get in a half decent lap, I'm going to try it on a low, low circuit. brilliant. Yeah, this race is going to be quite difficult for Painter Online. I also think it depends on the car. If you're going in a slower car, then it's probably a lot easier. Pretty shitty lap, but we'll take it for now. Try it on a normal circuit. Yeah, so a lot quicker than the Renault Megane trophy, obviously. Let's see some of the other records. Probably the Mercedes DTM. What track? What track should we go for here? Mercedes DTM. Let's use the ghost and see what the speed difference is between the Falcon and the Mercedes. What is going on? Yes, you. We'll just save it to all tracks. All right. My good friend Kai seems to be second in time trial. Hopefully if I can get first, I'll piss him off a little bit. Let's see if this car is any faster than the DTM then. Surely doesn't slow down like the DTM, Jesus. Got to brake a lot earlier in this car. Doesn't have the same type of grip as the Mercedes GTO. Difficult to drive than a Mercedes DTM. Mercedes DTM got mountains of grip, but this is a proper heavy car. You feel like you're driving a family saloon with a lot of grunt, which is basically what a Ford Falcon is. To say, gotta enjoy the challenge of this car. Wow, okay. Doors mainly turn up that side. Slow down. Sensitive to bumps, this car. I'm gonna go and have a look at setup. Normally what I'll try to do is drop the car down as low as possible, run it basically on the floor just to get the most out of the grip and stuff, but for this car I think you're just gonna be tempting fate unless you're gonna be driving on a super smooth track. Any track with bumps in them at some stage when you're pushing, you're gonna make a mistake. So I'm gonna have a look at the setup, see what I can do, sort all that out. I'm going to free practice, I think. And should we go back to Scotland? Yeah, why not? I do actually like this circuit a lot. It's got some nice corners. Reset the car back to stock, and first things first, we'll lower them tire pressures. Brakes I'm not too sure about yet, to be honest. Close the brake ducts down a bit. Didn't feel too bad. I had it on about 3 on the rear wing. Didn't feel too bad, but we'll go with 4 this time. Bit more front end. Put them down. And get rid of all that camber. Alright, get rid of the toe for now. Okay, so the stock ride height is pretty high. Front springs are quite low as well. Normally I like to run my springs a little higher, give it a better front end. Tends to cane the tires a bit, but if you drive careful you can still get the speed out of it. Put that rear stiffness down a little bit. And the bump stops are higher. I was actually running them on 6 and 0, I believe. That may be why. We'll put these up a little bit. 17,000 will go. 9.5. Now, whatever you do with the slow bumps, when moving your slow bumps up or down, you have to make sure that your slow rebounds are always either equal or higher. You're never supposed to have them lower, otherwise your car would handle like dog shit. So always make sure your slow rebounds are higher than your slow bumps. Fast rebounds, I'll leave them. And this is to stop oversteer over bumps and curbs. So I always put my fast rebounds, the fronts all the way to the right and the rear all the way to the left. So for instance, when you're going over jumps and your tires land back on the surface, they're not swerving all over the place with oversteer. That's the time when you do want understeer. That means your wheels won't turn as much. Can't actually touch the acceleration lock or deceleration, which is quite weird. Oh, you can't really move the gears individually. Leave it here. Brake mapping. Normally, ideally, you want to run with your brake mapping all the way down, but because you can't mess around with the deceleration, you've got nothing to really stop your car from losing it under braking. So only thing you can really affect that with is the brake mapping and probably a bit of rear wing. So we'll try and put it down to 6. That should give us better front end. I'll change my force feedback settings. A bit lighter. Right. That'll do. Normally body stiffness is actually on 100, but on this car for some reason it's on 0. I'm gonna put it to 100, see what it does. Starting off with blue tires. They're not a different learning. Thank you. something nice about being in a right-hand drive car on a British road. Such a good corner there. Braking just doesn't seem to work. Cool. Might be one of them cars you can get away with running like higher brake pressure if you know over there. Still struggling with the bumps. And I find it's mainly the rear. Soften that suspension, I think. Put that back down. Try and put the brake pressure up. We'll try and run 100 YOLO. Completely forgot where I was. Go. I must say though, I definitely like the car. Slow down a lot better. Even on blue tires. focused on brake pressure. I feel as if I'm learning the track still. I don't think the bumps on this track, I don't think you could do anything about them in this car. The track's just extremely bumpy, even more than Nordschleife. There's a lot of jumps on this track. Corner is totally blown. Thank you. so hard. Wow. Yeah, that brake pressure's not working for me. 90. It's gotta be good on 90, right? Well, hopefully it is. Yeah, I mean, I can feel the front end turning in a little better. It's a bit like the SLS, sometimes you really got to force it. So I'm going to put the weight bias right at the front. And make my steering ratio a lot smaller. Two angles of toe. Guys have got project cars. This is actually this car itself is free. It's only the track that you have to pay for, but the car you can download for free. Yeah. Make sure you go and do that. Kind of trail brake, sorry, and doesn't seem to be working. I think it might be one of them cases you just got to slam on. thought I was gonna keep out of the wall then, but no chance. Fuck me. Just making that time I did in time trial look pretty decent, even though it was a shocking lap. 2:19. I think probably once everyone's hooked up on this track in this car, it's probably going to be around a 2:16, 2:15. Trying to slow down from high speed in this car is just, it is so odd. It's like it doesn't lock up, but it's like it just doesn't slow down. Very similar to the SLS. If you're using no ABS, of course. If you're using ABS, then pretty sure it'll slow down. Car feels alright, to be fair. Soften that right up as well. Retarded, am I? Thank you. again. Jesus Christ. Just doesn't want to slow down. We'll carry on. Wow. There's definitely the surface of the track when you go over certain bumps. The bumps, say if you're on the right side of the track, sometimes the right side of the track will be flat, but the left side will have a massive bump. So if you go slightly offline, it just completely throws you off. Very, very difficult track, but it's a good one for me anyway. It'll be harder than people think to overtake around here, because you hit that one bump and yeah, your race will be over. Put the comments on the side of the screen to see what you guys are saying. Hasn't been released on PC. I thought PC would add it first. Couldn't wait for this Ford Falcon. Yeah, maybe, hopefully, for you guys. It's a good car, it's definitely a good car. I tell you what, I've had enough of this circuit, it's damn near done. Yeah, I remember this is probably one of the first cars I used on the GT2 or 3. All I used to use was the Falcon. Back then I was on the control pad, but yeah, good cars, man. Take it to Bathurst. I'm actually completely shocking at this track, but hey. Another very bumpy track as well, isn't it? grip's not too bad around here. Wow. Until I did that. Got brake so early in this car is unbelievable. Can't actually put on any front wing in this car. Front wing just stuck. Let's see what happens if I just put it all the way up. Give us any extra grip. Try a bit of rear camber, I suppose. Go, go, go. I should probably actually try this car on a circuit that I'm actually half decent at. Not really a great fan of Bathurst. I mean, I don't mind watching the races that I've taken part. This car and curbs and bumps just do not match. so easy to get the car unsettled. It's a very good car, but it's definitely a very tough car. Gonna require a bit of practice. It's like the front end kind of feels like a Mercedes SLS GT3, but the rear end feels like a Ginetta GT3. So you've got a lot of understeer at the front, and you've got the odd bit of oversteer at the back, which is pretty weird. But I'm about to jump off this stream, and I've been on for about 2 hours, so probably you might want to jump on later at about 8 o'clock and watch Project Sideways on Twitch, and he'll be streaming the League Race and the Zach Speed from VR Room, so should be pretty decent. So that's Project Sideways on Twitch, 8 p.m. tonight UK time. Yeah, should be a decent race. But I'm gonna get off, man. Peace.